Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss with you the endotracheal tube. It's a curved tube which is placed in the trachea through mouth or nostril used for intubation. You know friends, the tubes were previously made up of latex, but currently plastic tubes are preferred because they are softer, less irritant to the mucosa, they are disposable, so less chances of infection, hypoallergenic, and moreover, as you can see, they are transparent, so there is easy visualization of the blockage of the tube due to blood, pus or secretions. Now let us talk about the parts of the ET tube. We start from the proximal end. As you can see, there is a 15mm adapter or connector which fits to a ventilator or the ambu bag. Now we move on to the central portion of the tube. You can see a vocal cord guide, which is the black line. It should be placed at the level of the opening of the vocal cords so that the tip of the ET tube is positioned above the bifurcation of the trachea. Second part, there is a radio opaque marker which is essential for the accurate visualization of the position of the ET tube within the trachea by means of an X-ray. The third part is the cuff in case of a cuffed ET tube. Friends, the use of this cuff is to provide a seal against the tracheal wall and prevent gases from leaking past the cuff. It also allows positive ventilation and prevents matter from entering into the trachea. As you can see in this diagram, there are two types of cuff. There is low pressure high volume and high pressure low volume cuff. The advantage of this cuff is that there is less chances of tracheal necrosis and ischemia, but the disadvantage is that due to larger contact area, it can run into folds and there are increased chances of aspiration. Whereas in high pressure, the seal is good, but it results in high tracheal necrosis and ischemia. Majority of the cuffs used are low pressure, high volume cuffs. The cuffed ET tubes are used in children greater than 8 years and the uncuffed are used in less than 8 years because they have a narrow subglottic area which itself functions as a cuff and prevents the ET tube from slipping. Now regarding the inflation of this cuff, we use a syringe. There is a small tube which runs alongside the ET tube and there is a pilot balloon at the proximal end of the small tube. This pilot balloon has a one-way valve which we press, and then you can see when we press the syringe, the cuff gets inflated. Now because of this one-way valve, we can check the pressure of the cuff and also it remains inflated because of this one-way valve. Now if the cuff is leaking, then we can check the pressure by the pilot valve. If it's leaking, then it will collapse. Second, we talk about the distal end of the ET tube. As you can see, there's a Murphy's eye. The use of this Murphy's eye is that once the ET tube, this part of the ET tube gets blocked with blood, pus or secretions, the gas flow still continues through this Murphy's end. But if the Murphy's eye was not present, then the ET tube would have got blocked. Then we have the tip, a smooth atraumatic tip of the ET tube. The smooth atraumatic tip of the ET tube, which is beveled. Mostly we have a left facing bevel. As you can see, there are two types of bevel. These are the vocal cords. This is left facing, this is right facing bevel. Now in a left facing bevel, the ET tube provides a better view because as visualizing through the laryngoscope blade, whereas in right facing, it gets obstructed if we see through the laryngoscope. Now talking about the size of the ET tube, the size refers to its internal diameter. So if you ask me for a size 5, then you're asking me for internal diameter of 5mm. As you can see, it's written internal diameter 5mm and outer diameter 6.9mm. As you can see here, this refers to the internal diameter and this refers to the outer diameter. Now talking about the length markings, as you can see, 12 cm, 14 cm, 16, 18 and 20 cm. This is done after inserting the endotracheal tube by means of reference to a landmark such as incisor teeth or lips. This is to see if the endotracheal tube has moved outwards or further into the bronchus. If the ET tube is too long, it can result in kinking and it can get obstructed. So this was all about the parts of the ET tube and their significance. Thank you.